my name, given to me at birth, is Glenton. The name that I have chosen for myself is Liberty. My pronouns are he, she, they, so I really don't mind using any one of the three of them. I identify as a gender non-conforming person, and hence also being placed at gender dynamic being so ideal for me, being a transgender-led and a transgender-specific organization doing human rights work, both within South Africa as well as within the sub-regions in Africa. Some of the wonderful work that I've been doing on behalf of the organization has been around lobbying for change at national level. We're also providing sensitization training education for healthcare practitioners around how to provide gender-affirming healthcare within the South African context. For a trans and gender-diverse person, moving into a clinic, a public healthcare facility, it is important that you are able to feel comfortable with the first person you come into contact with, and that first is important, which is usually the administrator. Second to that, what happens within the screening rooms where people are screened by healthcare practitioners around their health needs. Healthcare providers should feel free to engage fully with a trans and gender diverse person to be able to assess what their particular healthcare needs are. So for me, it has been really riveting and exciting doing the work that I'm doing, particularly working at community level, then linking this very high level advocacy that we are doing with service providers training, but also being able to spend time and work with the community members themselves. Because if we are just going to be advocating high levelly and not being able to monitor what's currently happening on the ground, it means that we are going to be divorced from the lived realities of people. So I often go into these spaces and conduct a trans 101 session, a sexual orientation, gender identity, the 2-1-1 session, and through that session, it's not about imposing information. It is really about trying to understand how is it that people identify, or how do people identify themselves on the ground within their context, and not necessarily imposing this very Western discourse around human rights for LGBTI person, but what do we have to work with within this country context? What do we have to work with within this community context, and how we can use that to lobby for change with our leaders, with our service providers, with our allies, with our change agents, and be able to collectivize our efforts in being able to really consolidate that change that we want to see within society.